new developments today in the Penn State scandal. Attorneys for ousted Penn State President Graham Spanier met with reporters this morning in Philadelphia to dispute allegations that Spanier covered up reports of sex abuse involving Jerry Sandusky. News 8's Barbara Barr was there, and she joins us live on the telephone with more on what they had to say. Barbara.
Susan, the attorneys for Dr. Spanier delivered a blistering attack of Judge Freeh and his report. Among other things, they called it a myth, a distortion of facts, and a blundering and indefensible indictment of Dr. Spanier. They say that Judge Freeh made himself a self-appointed accuser who, in an effort to protect the victims of a monster, Jerry Sandusky, created more victims. They went on to say that a dead man could not respond to the Freeh report, meaning Joe Paterno, and that two Penn State administrators could also not respond because they are facing charges of perjury and failure to report. But they said Dr. Spanier can and will respond, and said that he never received a report of any sexual activity involving Jerry Sandusky or anything of a criminal nature, or they said he would have done something and stopped the predator.
And he has not ever, not one time ever, wavered from the facts, what the facts make very clear, which is that he was never told that there was anything of a sexual nature involving Jerry Sandusky and a minor. Never has he wavered from that. Had he known, he would have taken immediate action. And there was never any effort or conspiracy to conceal anything from anyone.
And the attorneys would not actually address an email that was raised that Dr. Spanier reportedly wrote in right after the McQuarrie report of sexual abuse and seeing Sandusky in the shower. Spanier is reported to have written an email to Curley and Schultz saying that the only concern is if we don't report it now, there could be concern down the road. His attorneys would not address what he meant by that or why he wrote that email. They said he will defend himself, and we have learned he is expected to appear on ESPN tonight. That's Dr. Graham Spanier. So we may, for the first time, hear in his own words his own defense of what happened and what he thinks of Louis Freeh's report. But more interesting developments here in Philadelphia, Susan.
Absolutely. And Spanier wasn't there, Barbara?
He was not there at the press conference. They just said you will be hearing from him later today, and he is apparently going to make an appearance tonight on a network, and perhaps we will hear much more about that email he wrote, which has just been so indicting of he, Curley Schultz, and Joe Paterno.
All right. Very good. Thank you, Barbara.